Today, I'm going to do the transmission oil and differential oil service.
Also, break some screws, spill some oil, and dip some plugs.
Whoa, I lost.
Hello, it's Carl again. Today, I'm going to do the transmission oil and differential oil service. Please refer to my previous video about how I jacked up the car and did the engine oil service. Let's start our push-up exercise now.
It is risky to get under the car that is floating in the air. Please do everything to protect yourself and your precious car. Safety first. In the video about replacing the oxygen sensors, I had to remove the underbody protection cover, which is also the transmission cover. Please see that video for this part, but I'm sure it is easy for you.
The protection cover is removed. This is the front side of the car, and we can see the filler plug and drain plug. On the other side of the gearbox, this is the strainer screw or filter screw. First, release the drain plug with 8mm hex bit.
Ooh, how does that look?
Also, the filler plug. Okay, the filler plug is also out. Take a look at the oil here.
Pretty dark. The service manual says change manual transmission gearbox oil every 75,000 kilometers for the M3. I'm not comfortable with this, so I will change it every year.
Several minutes passed and the draining is almost complete. The manual says we have to use the computer to run the gear oil pump to drain out the remaining oil in the system.
Activate gear oil pump using DIS tester for approximately 30 seconds. So using text search, oil pump, search for oil pump. Okay, we already see this ABL transmission oil pump activation. This option will show up once you connected the car to the computer. So we display continue. The transmission oil pump can be activated in the next test step. So option one, activation to drain the transmission oil. Okay, select number one, continue. Do you want to activate transmission pump now for 30 seconds? Yes. Continue. Transmission oil pump is switched off. Go to selection. And the service. Okay, this is done. So, this is the oil pump of the gearbox. If you don't have a PC, you don't have an Insta, you can also activate the pump by just supplying 12 volt power to it. Let's disconnect its power. This is a connector on the gearbox oil pump. I removed its pins and I'm going to insert another two wires to supply the DC power. So pin number one is positive. Pin number two is ground. So we just reconnect the connector into the oil pump and connect battery. The oil pump will run.
Okay,
there. Oh, 30 seconds. A lot of oil inside. Wow. 25, 26, 27. Okay, about 30 seconds. Okay, after we activated the oil pump to drain the remaining oil, we restore this drain screw. I wrapped Teflon seal tape on the aluminum drain plug, but this can damage it if we tighten to the original torque. So watch. Okay, the specified torque for this drain plug is 35 Newton meter. Okay, I can see this aluminum drain plug is broken. I had to replace that. I'll leave it there, don't touch it until we replace new one. Next, the strainer plug. We need a 22 millimeter hexagonal socket to release it. Okay, it's released. So it's actually a filter. The torque for the strainer plug is 25 Newton meter. Okay, 25. Okay, this is the oil I use for the manual gearbox, Castrol Transmax manual 75W. And the oil required by BMW is MTF LT2, 2.1 liter according to the service manual. Okay, 1 liter in. It is strongly recommended to use professional oil pumping tools. You are going to see how bad I'm doing this. Okay, I need to pump another one. Greasy, greasy. Another bottle, ready. Now about 1.5 liter in there. Okay, it is dripping. So I think almost okay. Okay, it is full, so the oil drips out. This is really a mess. After we top up the oil, we have to run the oil pump for 30 seconds again. About 30 seconds, we have to top up the oil. Fill the port is around here. Go in, please. Now you see these cheap plastic tools don't do the job. This is really difficult. Here's this end. So all the oil go in, please. Okay. Thank you. Okay, the torque for the filler screw is also 35 Newton meter. Okay, good. Okay, time to restore everything. There are five screws, five black screws. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These five look the same with our 8mm hex socket, but there are two longer and three shorter. The three shorters are here, 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 and the two longers are on the sides. So not to mix with this one, because if you insert the longer screw here, that is going to contact with the oil sump and leave a machine mark there.
Okay.
Front. Good. Okay, now we are at the rear differential. There are two screws, the drain plug and the filler plug screw. We are going to use 22mm hex bit to release them. And the tightening torque for these two screws are 60 Newton meters. That's quite a lot. So expect a lot of force to release them. Yes, indeed. That was really hard. So let's ask help from the big brother of the ratchet wrench. That should be enough. Let's try this. Yeah, that's easier, way easier.
I lost my screw.
Hello. The torque for tightening these screws are 60 Newton meters. All right, now the filler plug. Okay, released. This is the differential oil I use this time, Castrol Transmax Limited Slip 75W-140. And the oil required by BMW is SAF QXJ, 1.1 liter according to the service manual. Well, that sounds bad. That's still half liter there. When you feel until the oil is dripping out, that's the amount of it. Around 1.5 liter. So now we can restore this plug. Okay, 60 Newton meter. Good. Brake cleaner. And also these greasy parts. All right, see you next time.
That's all for the transmission oil and differential oil service. Look at so many oil waste I have got, but I still got power steering fluid and brake fluid service to do. So please stay tuned. Cheers.